Weird Engine Swaps are finally back. It's been quite long, hasn't it? It's been like 1.5 years since the last episode. But yeah, we are back with four bangers, four really unusual cars, if you want. And yeah, we're gonna jump straight into the first one. A Dodge Hellcat. But it's not really a Hellcat anymore. Someone over on Discord hit me up and he was like, do you wanna drive a Hell Tesla? And I was like, a what? A Hell? You mean like a mix of the two? And he was like, yes. And I was like, yes, give me that car. That sounds awesome. I really want to give that one a shot. And here it is. And it doesn't crash the game, which is kind of impressive. And I can't believe I'm saying this, but we're gonna quickly rev it up and see what it sounds like. That's a very unusual sound from an Hellcat. That's an abomination right there. Like, that's the sort of thing you really shouldn't be doing in real life. But then again, if you can do it in a game, why not give it a shot? I mean, that's an interesting car right there. I wouldn't mind driving that one in real life. And yeah, it's not that quick yet. It's basically a stock Tesla for now. We're gonna change that later on. But yeah, let's do a quick 0 to 100 test just to see how fast a Tesla-powered Hellcat really is. I mean, that's not bad. Like, that's quicker than my car, so I can't really complain about that one. But there is one more thing. There is one more thing I do wanna try before we make it a bit quicker in a straight line or before we jump into our next car. Because that Hellcat right there still has one major flaw we might be able to fix with the help of the dev menu. And yeah, we're gonna open up the hood real quick and we should be able to see, fingers crossed, there we go, that's the engine of the Hellcat, which, you know, is no longer in the car, technically, so we're gonna try and remove it. Hopefully this works. If it works, it would be kind of neat. Okay, so car scene, car part operations, that's very good. Car body, here we go. Okay, can remove the engine from the car? That's the big question right now. Let's see, engine bay, we don't want to remove the... Oh, engine. There we go, that was easy. Was that the right one? It was, yes! That's pretty neat. Like, that's a pretty neat little trick. And now, I guess, it's kind of realistic. I mean, while we're here, we might as well take a look at the other customization options, because why not? We can tint the headlights. That could look kind of interesting. Ooh, that looks very mean. But you know what? I actually prefer the normal ones, not gonna lie. They look pretty cool. What else can we... Taillight... Ooh, can we debadge it? Yes, realistically, we should put a Tesla logo right there. That would make sense, but let's keep it that way. Actually, let's keep it that way, because it's not really a Dodge anymore. Okay, so here we are in the upgrade shop, and as you can see, we can now officially change motor and battery on a Dodge Challenger Hellcat, which is kind of jokes. And yeah, we're gonna see what sort of power bump we can get. Oh, that's juicy. That is juicy. How much power is that? Let's... Oh, that's... That's an unhealthy amount of horsepower right there, but also a very fun amount of horsepower. Can you smell the tire smoke already? What else have we got? We're not gonna swap in an engine, because that's just asking for a game crash, a very nasty one. Gearbox, we can't really change that one, it's a Tesla gearbox. Brakes, we could use some better brakes. Okay, so here we are in our Hell Tesla with the ripped out engine. It's a bit of an abomination, but I do want to see how fast it goes in a straight line, because we are, after all, mighty powerful. So we're going to rev it up and go. Come on. Oh. That was 340. That shouldn't be a thing. That should not be a thing. A Hellcat without engine noise. That... I feel like I'm doing something illegal here. Oh, I just want to keep going. Oh my god. Oh my god. That was kind of scary. What was that? Okay, interior view is slightly bugged. I don't really know why, and I don't really want to know why. It sounds like a spaceship, doesn't it? It sounds really strange. Kind of, I like it. So here we are in our next car, and as you can probably guess already by the theme of this video, that beautiful V12 engine... It's no longer in that LaFerrari right there. Instead, I swapped it out for the exact opposite. A diesel engine. A diesel engine from the Nissan Titan pickup truck. Yes, I actually did that. And I do want to take it for a quick test drive in an off-road race, but that would be kind of boring. So, that's the LaFerrari we're going to be driving. A proper off-road LaFerrari. Another abomination of a car. But it's really cool and really powerful. We are talking way over 1,000 horsepower. Loads of suspension travel. Big tires. And quite a lot of grip. Not gonna lie, as weird as it looks, and I know it looks weird, this is gonna be a decent off-road car. Oh, look at the power. Brakes are decent, actually. I didn't change the brakes. I think they're still stock, which is probably not the best idea I've ever had, but there we go. Oh, look at the way just swallows up the bombs. So I wish we could do that sort of stuff in a normal game, because that is hilarious. I could build those cars all day long and, you know, race them all day long. Just because it's so different to what you can usually do in a game, it's just very entertaining. And by the way, we are ripping. Like, this is driving against unbeatable AI. I mean, I guess the other Ferraris haven't got that much power? They might actually. I'm not too sure. This is all getting a bit confusing if you change values in the game files. I mean, this is a better off-road car than some of the actual off-road cars I've built in my past. Look at it go. Oh, what a car. I'm in love. Shush, shush. Just press the Anna button and I'll assist you. Yeah, I won't ever. Hey, monkey, I've identified another potential. Oh, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. That just made my day. Oh, another one. They won't even stop spawning. What have I done? What have I created? But yeah, time to jump into the next car and time to try something that you could potentially even try in real life if you are a bit crazy. Okay, so here we are with our mini Regera. I call it mini Regera because it's pretty much a Regera, just a little bit smaller and it's also a mini. Get it? So it's a mini Regera. Anyway, let's see. Oh, it's actually kind of difficult to control. Come on, in a straight line. There we go. There we go. Holy mother of wheel spin. And by the way, I can't shift up. I also switched in the gearbox from the Regera. So we've only got one gear. We could theoretically hit that top speed in reverse as well, which we might actually try later on. Okay, so here we are in stage 2 of our Regera Mini. And as you can see, I've made some slight modifications to our cute little Mini Cooper. A bit of a wider track, some super wide and super sticky tires, custom made for our Mini. So right now, oh, that's not a good sign. That's not a good sign. Top speed 0 kilometers per hour. Fingers crossed it works. It should work. I've tested it before. How much power are we pushing? Yeah, that's like near enough 15,000 horsepower. Oh my god, the entire car shakes. That's always a good sign for a very fun car. But let's see, can we launch it off the line? Always a bit tricky with super grippy cars. Okay, I no idea what... I mean, we are on our four wheels, so I'll take it. We're just gonna floor it. We're just gonna floor it and see how fast we can go. 770 and brake right down. Yeah, I did upgrade the brakes as well, because, you know, stock mini brakes won't really cut it. My voice is now completely dead, as you can probably tell, but there is one more thing. There is one more thing we have to try, and that's driving in reverse in our Regera powered mini, just for the funsies, because, you know, while we're here, we might as well, and I just want to see how fast we can go in reverse, pretty much. So yeah, gently does it. Gently on the throttle, come on. Oh, that sounds broken. That sounds broken. I mean, we're moving. Like, 400. 500 in reverse? That's a madness. Oh my god. Just floor it. Boot it. Come on. 600? Oh, not quite. Not quite. Well, we didn't quite crack 600 kilometers per hour in reverse, but I think 500 in reverse in a Regera-powered Mini, that's not too bad. Like, that's pretty good going for a Mini Cooper. So, yeah. I think I'm gonna leave it there, and we're gonna jump into the next car and back to my normal voice. So here we are in the new Ford GT, a rather good sounding car in my opinion, at least in Forza Horizon 3. That engine sound is pretty damn good for a V6 engine. Yes, that car has got a V6 EcoBoost engine, but what if it didn't? What if someone was to swap out the engine for something a bit more American? Now, I'm not gonna put in any random V8 engine. Instead, I'm gonna put in that engine right there. A 5.4 liter V8 engine supercharged, and I'm pretty sure some of you guys can already guess what engine that is. That's the V8 from the original Ford GT. Interesting. Very unusual for a new Ford GT. So we're gonna drive through the tunnel. You know what? I'm actually gonna put up a little poll right here where you guys can vote on either V6 or V8, which engine sound fits better to the new Ford GT. Let me know by, you know, voting in that little poll right here. I'm curious, because I feel like the V6 sounds better in that car, but I don't know. Oh, that's neat. It's almost like Forza Vista on the road. That's really cool. Can we drive the car? Now, can we see the shifting animation? That's the big question right now. Oh, we can! Oh, that's such a neat feature. Why is that not a thing in a normal game? Like, why can't we do that sort of stuff in a normal game? That's awesome! Just let me do silly stuff in games, aww. You know what? I'm gonna give it a single rev, and I'm pretty sure most of you guys can already tell what engine is in the Porsche right now. Now again, I didn't like the old school engine sound in the new Ford GT, but I do like the engine sound of a Carrera GT in a 918 Spider. If I was a multi-billionaire in real life, I would totally buy a 918 Spider, rip out the hybrid system and put in a V10 from the Carrera GT, because it's possible, you just need a load of money and some pretty good engineers, I think, to make this work, but I mean, if you have the money spare and you have a couple 918s in your garage, you might as well. You can probably tell by my voice, I quite like it. And I think to end the video, we're gonna do one last tunnel run in the 918 Carrera GT Spider. Which, actually, come to think of it, it's not actually a spider. We need to take the roof off. Can we take the roof off? Let's see. Can we take the roof off the 918 Spider? I think we can. We should be able to, right? I mean, we can do it in Forza Vista. Let's see. Have we got a roof? Oh, we have! Roof open. Whoa. That just flew off. That was a good sounding tunnel run, but I think I'm gonna leave it there. I hope you guys found it funny. I hope you guys found this interesting. If you did, make sure to drop a like on it. As always, very much appreciated. Subscribe for more Forza and Need for Speed videos in the future. And until next time, bye.